hi again. So it's been a while since I showed like a haul video. That's because I've been kind of good about shopping. I haven't really been shopping. Okay, I have, but I mean, it's not like I've been spending like $300 that whole day. At least in makeup, just saying. But okay, let's just go ahead and go on to the haul video. This is specifically showcasing Sephora, of course, because Sephora is like my number one go-to to shop. I would definitely do a like drugstore and like Ulta haul soon because I did accumulate some stuff from Ulta and the drugstore. So stay tuned for that. But for now, enjoy my Sephora haul. So I got this thing during the VIB sale, which happened like almost a month ago. As you can see, like, I already took it out of the box, so I don't even know why I'm showing the box. I'm just gonna go ahead and throw the box away. But just in case you're curious what the box looks like, it is like this. And this is from Caudalie. And this is what products it comes with, which I will be showing you very soon. So this is the Caudalie set that's called Founder Favorite Set. And the specific reason why I got it was because I wanted to try the Caudalie Vino Perfect Serum. It's a radium serum, basically great for hyperpigmentation and discoloration in the skin. Again, I have acne prone skin and I pick up my face a lot. So I have a lot of hyperpigmentation. I got like dark spots right here and right here, right here, right here, right here. So basically all over my face. I've been using brightening serums like the Ulla Henriksen Truth Serum, which I personally love. But of course I want to see if there's anything better out there. This bad boy is $79 alone, and it's for one fluid ounce for this thing. I mean, it's a lot, and the packaging is glass and it's pretty heavy. It's a dropper, but I didn't want to pay $79 just for this thing. So when I was doing some research online, Makeup by Tiffany D, which I love her, I've been following her since, I don't know, before she got married. But she suggested this in her video, but what she suggested to get it with is the set. And the set actually comes with a beauty elixir, which is, I guess it's basically, it's a toner. So it's going to help you, it's going to help smooth out your skin texture and also help you give you the dewy glow, which I don't really care for, but I mean, it came in the set and it's $79 for this one thing anyway, so I don't mind. And it also comes with an eye cream, which is probably like a small version of it, and it is the Premier Crew Eye Cream. It says it addresses all signs of aging, so we'll see about that. Most likely it's probably just fine lines and wrinkles. And then this one, which I'm also excited to try out, this is supposedly Caudalie's new mask, and it's the Instant Detox Mask, and this helps minimize and deep clean pores. So of course it's just a little mini size, but I don't mind. I like trying things out before I invest in like a big size. So yeah, it comes with all of these for $79. I don't mind, especially since this bad boy is already $79 on its own. So because I'm like filming this around Mother's Day, or on Mother's Day actually, I actually purchased this. It's the Versace Bright Crystal perfume. I've been meaning to buy this for the longest time, and what better way to buy a perfume when Sephora has the 3x points thing going on. So I went ahead and got the 3.3 fluid ounce because I love the Versace Bright Crystal and I've been out of it for years, and I don't know why I haven't gotten it before, but now that I have it, I'm like, oh, okay, welcome back into my life. This bad boy is sold out everywhere, so I'm very sorry if you cannot get your hands on this anymore, but it's the Sephora Favorites Skinstant Radiance. Oh, I didn't even know that said that. Get it? It's like instant radiance, but it's like Skinstant Radiance. Okay, that probably didn't seem cool to you, but anyways, this is exclusive to Sephora inside JCPenney stores. Unfortunately, it's not online. So if you can find it, I would suggest getting it. It's only $35 for this, and look what it comes with. So you've already seen in my last video that I purchased the NARS All Day Luminous Weightless Foundation. I am in love with this. This was in my last favorites video. I just can't. I don't know what else to say about this stuff. It's like literally a full coverage foundation. that gives me a nice satin glow. It's just amazing. I mean, it's not super dewy, but it's not super matte. And I like that because, again, there's times where my face just wants to, I don't know, just have these dry patches around. And I hate, like, when foundation clings onto it. So this is a foundation that does not cling onto dry patches. And seriously, you only need one pump, if anything, less than two. Another foundation that I've been using and that I'm currently wearing right now is the Becca Ever Matte Shine Proof Foundation. It is getting to be the summertime, so I've been using something that's a little bit more on the matte side, shiny. So I've been using something that's going to give me a little bit more of a matte finish because, again, I am oily and I do like matte finishes. I just don't like it when it clings onto my matte skin. But the Becca Ever Matte Shine Proof Foundation does not, like, cling on to dry patches for me, at least for now, because, again, it doesn't seem like my dry patches are coming out. So I love this, especially if you want a matte foundation. So Urban Decay never fails when they come out with eyeshadows. So I got their new eyeshadows. It's like a dual intensity chrome type of eyeshadow. I actually wore this already, but it's the color Lounge, and the color Lounge, it's like this brown green color, a beautiful forest green brown color. It's crazy, like, different if you use different bases, you'll see the different chromes to it. The other one that I got is Tonic, and this is like a nice purple blue. I don't know, like, it changes every time. Like, it's hard to, like, swatch it here in the camera, and because I didn't open it yet, but yeah, I love this, these two eyeshadows. Granted, they're like 18-20 bucks, but Sephora right now is having, like, sales on some of their brushes. I guess different Sephora stores vary, so I'm not really sure what's on sale at other stores. But I went and got the blending eyeshadow. It's just the black Sephora one. Like this. I don't even know. It's like, these are the classic brushes. This was on sale for $12.99. I don't even know how much it was originally. I think it was like 20 something for this. So I think it's just literally a blending brush. The one that's like tapered a little bit more. But $12.99 online, because Sephora brushes can really get really pricey. This Kabuki brush was probably 40 bucks, if anything 30. And it was on sale for $23.99, and it comes in a little cute pouch. And it's this one right here. This is the number 43 Pro Kabuki brush. Ah, I almost dropped it. But I need a new Kabuki brush because I have like two, and I think I lost one, so I need things to set my makeup with. So yeah, I can't wait to use that once I clean it. Okay, so the nude, like, lips or the dark lips have not fade out into, like, what is it called? Like, it has, it's still hip, I guess you can say. So I got the Buxom True Nude Lip Foundation in the color Revealed, and it's literally this nice chocolate color. It's like Swiss chocolate from MAC, I guess you can say. That's like the most that I can, or the color that I can really compare it to. So I got that. Again, going back to skincare, I finally invested into Peter Thomas Roth, the AHA/BHA acne clearing gel. So I got the Peter Thomas Roth, the AHA/BHA clearing gel treatment, specifically, again, for my acne, because it does have 2% salicylic acid in it. It also has glycolic acid in it, which is actually going to help exfoliate my skin, and licorice root to help my pigmentation for my acne scars. So far, I actually do like it because it hasn't broken me out, for one. This is a little bit more not for the sensitive skin, just saying, because it is a little bit more in the chemical-based product-wise. So I get really skeptical about using these things, and I get skeptical when something's like $65 and you're like, should I buy it? Should I not buy it? But so far, so good. I have been obsessed with sheet masks lately. I've used one already. If you follow me on Snapchat, you've already seen it, but I cannot wait to use the Karuna face masks. I got one in the Brightening Plus face mask. The Brightening face mask and the Clarifying face mask. Of course, one is for brightening up my complexion, and the other one is great for acne-prone skin to help kind of with my pigmentation and kind of help tame down the inflammation on my acne. So I can't wait to use these. I mean, these were like $8 each, I want to say. So this one's the one from Sephora collection. This is the magnifying and blemish mask. So it's the green tea mask, hopefully really great for blemishes. I don't want it to break me out. So yeah, these are like $6. I mean, these are really, really fun. I've been really into the sheet masks lately, so yeah, we'll see how that goes. Throw it in there. I finally got this. I knew I wanted it, but I was kind of like skeptical about getting it. It's the new, I almost like cut my throat right there. It's the new Kat Von D Shade and Light for the Eyes palette. Amazing. And there's your colors. Gorgeous. I cannot wait to use this one. This is the NARS Contour Duo. What are they called? Or Duo. But this is in the color Paloma. I really, first of all, I wanted to get this color because it's like the first half of my last name. But mainly because, of course, it is for my skin complexion, my skin tone. I cannot wait to use this thing. Seriously, it's... The only reason why I'm holding back on it is because I'm trying to finish my MAC one, and I've had my MAC one for years and it needs to go, and that's what I'm currently wearing right now. Just saying in case you're wondering. Holy crap, that's it for my Sephora haul. I thought I had a bajillion more, but I guess that was all that I had. Well, there you go. I hope that wasn't boring. Anyways, that is it for my Sephora haul. Again, stay tuned for another random haul because I will be giving that soon. Again, comment, rate, subscribe. Any requests, leave them down below. Follow me on my social media, on my Instagram, on my Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter, my life, whatever. I will link them all down below, of course, for you. I will see you guys. Bye-bye.